If you've made it this far in the course, welcome back. I'm so proud of you, man. I know this is a lot of info to take in and put into your practice, but man, I bet you're seeing a difference by now. And you can't forget that all of these little details that you're learning throughout this course are things that are going to be with you through your whole musicianship. So be sure that you're only practicing these things one at a time until they feel natural, then start integrating the other things. Today, I am going to give you probably the best tip I ever had when it comes to understanding rhythm better, and that is the basic breakdown of all rhythm. Believe it or not, it never really gets more difficult or more complex than twos and threes. Today, you're going to learn how to speak these rhythms so you can communicate them better with other people. You're going to learn how to read the written rhythm associated with the two and associated with the three. We're going to learn how to practice them. And we're going to learn how you can use them to better express yourself and further improve your strumming and your single note picking in the future. With that being said, let's get to it. My name's Mac Ray Keaton, and this is Scattered Theory. So first things first, let's go ahead and say we know what two sounds like. That is our one beat being split in half, one and. It looks like this for a good reference. And if you add the other three beats, it looks like that. Every beat is just split in half. Now we get into the nitty-gritty, splitting them into three. An old college friend of mine named Charles Burdett, he was a drummer and he played on the drum line, could speak drums like no one I ever heard before in my life. I used to watch him practice his routine, just speaking it with his mouth. Dat, dat, diggity, dat, 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 diggity, 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 dat. And I'm like, what are you doing? Why are you making those noises? And he's like, well, when I do eighth notes, or when I do groups of twos, at least, I go di, ga. So the downbeat is duh, or di, D-I-H, and you make that noise with the tip of your tongue. The second noise is g, that is the and of the beat. That's the upbeat. So if you want to split it in half, you would say de, g. Keep in mind the g is produced in the back of the mouth, so your tongue should be making this tipping motion. Whenever we split the beat into three, however, we add another d on the end of that group of noises. So de, g, du. De, g, du. Speaking rhythm like this is the easiest and fastest way to hear and analyze any rhythm that you want to. So if I hear something that sounds like da 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 da, I can go digga da digga da da. That those are groups of three. Don't turn it off. We're gonna do all of this with a metronome here in a little bit. Now when we speak rhythm, instead of saying one and, we say one and da. I want you to avoid this in the beginning only because I don't like how smooth those words are. I don't like saying one and because it's not precise enough. These rhythms have to be right where they need to be. And the only way to do that is to do it with a metronome. But if you're saying words that take a lot of effort to say, like one, then you may be dragging that beat more than you think. It might ruin the way you're trying to hear the rhythm. So what I want you to do is when we start doing this with a metronome, I want you to only use the drum speak in the beginning and then start counting with it to find your place in the triplet. But before you hear the triplet, you'll never be able to count with it. So you got to trust me. You got to go digga da up until it feels natural to you. So let's talk about how we can practice speaking rhythm with a metronome. This is a picture of the metronome I showed you in a couple lessons ago when we were talking about what a metronome was. In this particular app that I use, that you can click this button up here in the corner, and a menu will pop up from the bottom giving you different types of subdivisions. Now, it may seem a little jumbled, but the only ones I want you to focus on is the two eighth notes and the triplets. When you set the metronome to the click that you want, 35, I know you guys are tired of that. The metronome will provide the subdivision for you without you having to do any math. So if your beat is 30, and you click the eighth note button, one, and you hit the triplet button, So that's an easy way to find your threes or your twos, but maybe you don't have money. Maybe you don't have the $5 or $6 to get you a metronome map so you can get those subdivisions working for you. I have a really cool alternate that you can use to practice with. So this is a screen grab of the metronome that pops up when you Google the word metronome. I have it on 40 beats per minute. And at 40 beats per minute, that metronome sounds like this. So that's my beat. I would count numbers on this. 1, 2, 3, 4. If I want to hear what my eighth note subdivision would sound like, this is the subdivision that you strum to, the 1 and, all I have to do is double that BPM. So instead of 40 beats per minute, I have 80 beats per minute. And that sounds like this. 1 and 2. This is a super easy way to find your eighth note subdivision if you don't have an app or something like that to do the work for you. Just double your BPM. Now what if you want to hear the triplet BPM? Because this is the one that's going to be tricky anyways. All you have to do is times your initial BPM by 3. Or add it twice. So our initial was 40, we add it once, we got 80. We add it one more time, we have 120. With this setting, 120 is what the BPM is, right? That's what it says. That's what you set your metronome to. But your real beat is 40 beats per minute. Why is this important to hear? Because there are two types of meter, for the most part, when it comes to music. You have twos or duple time, threes or triple time. You don't have to know how to read time signatures to hear if it's in two or three. You just have to be able to hear if it's di, ga, di, ga, or di, ga, da, di, ga, da. Some good examples are like Tennessee Whiskey. It's in three. And if you listen to it, you'll hear the bum, 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 da, da, di, ga, da, di, ga, da. Or like Uptown Funk is in two. Boom, do, 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 one, and two, and three, and four, and. You need to be able to hear these types of rhythm to master your rhythm. I can't stress enough how hearing two and hearing three in the space of one beat will benefit your playing in the future. So if you can't hear the rhythm, then speak the rhythm, you can't play the rhythm. So you gotta trust me, sit with your metronome, do the drum speak, di-ga, di-ga for twos, and the drum speak, di-ga-da, di-ga-da for threes. Do not let yourself count with a metronome unless it is on every click. So make sure that that metronome is set to click every time you make a new syllable with your mouth. Now let's talk about how to play triple time with our strumming hand. So when it comes to strumming triple time, so many people have problems with this because there are multiple ways to do it. The natural go-to is for people to do all downstrokes. 1, 2, 3. And this is good. It's easy, especially if you're doing slow, like country tunes, like waltz type tunes. All downstrokes will work just fine. But what happens when you're doing something faster? Something that's like digga-da, 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 digga-da. It's a little too much, right? So we need to treat this triplet the same way we treated our eighth notes when we were learning strumming patterns. The only difference is now you get to control when you go up and when you go down. There are really only two other ways to strum triplets. The first one is to keep the hand going down and up no matter what, but this gets really hard to get used to, especially in the beginning if you don't understand triplets, because that means you'll be strumming up on a downbeat. My personal favorite, the one I use the most when it comes to strumming, is down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. This helps me get a really nice accent on the downbeat of every measure instead of trying to get a good fat sound coming up on a downbeat, like if we were going to go down, up, down, up, down, up. I highly recommend only doing down strums at first, then jump up to down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. Then after that, your ear for triplets should be good enough to where you can focus on controlling going up on a downbeat. Good rule of thumb, if you don't know what type of strumming on this hand to use with the song that you're learning, is if it's slow, it's good to stick with all down. That way you can get those upstrokes in between. If you're playing something a little more medium tempo, I would suggest the down, up, down, down, up. Then when it comes to faster tempos, this is where your knowledge has to be better than your hands. Because if you're not hearing these rhythms and speaking these rhythms before you play them, you won't be able to play them. You gotta trust me on that. Oh, that'd be... So keep in mind, you're not supposed to practice these slow, medium, and fast. But if you ever get confused on what type of strumming you want to do with your right hand, look at the tempo first, and if it is in three, now you know your options. Those are really the only three options. Three down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, or down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Save that last one for last. So with that being said, I want you to tell me what your biggest struggle was when it comes to learning strumming patterns or hearing beats up till now. If this video helped clarify anything for you about how to hear threes or hear twos or your strumming when it comes to these things, let me know in the comments below. I want to answer your questions. I want to help you guys get better. If you haven't already, go to my Facebook page at Remember This Address, where I do a live stream every Wednesday and I'm promoting my music. It's just everything's going on that page. So if you want to know what's going on with me, go check that out. With that being said, the best time to practice is right after your lesson, so get your metronome, get to it, and if you can, try to be a little better today than you were yesterday.